Hey,
how are you? Look at
that, man. Cadet Romero.
Hey, Cadet Romero.
Nice to meet you. I'm Cadet Zinn.
Cadet Zinn, welcome.
Say hi to the vlog.
You gonna be in my vlog? Jackie! What's going on?
Oh,
shake hands. Shake hands.
He's silent when you go inside.
Sir. Shake hands.
So cool.
Phone going.
Hey. Nice seeing you again, sir. Nice to meet you.
When you get there. Mom, I can't go in until later.
What? This is the Stephen Chan baby.
Wait, I gotta duck down.
Oh, you
I'm too tall.
What's going on, dudes? How you doing?
Are you part of the Grog?
Alvarado. Again. Oh!
2 days ago. Yesterday.
Look at you!
About face.
Good evening, cadets.
Good evening.
When I tell you to fall out, we're gonna go fall out by the side door on the side of the gym. Do you understand where that is?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you're gonna wait. Group, fall out.
High school.
Let's go sit somewhere.
Bring forward our color guard to start this night off. So color guard, present the colors.
Guidance unto me, light, when so proudly we held at the twilight's last gleaming.
POW MIA tribute is a traditional ceremony formed at the beginning of formal military functions to remember those who could not be with those whom they served. AAE cadets will represent the services as follows. Cadet Wagaski, the United States Army. Cadet Sanchez, the United States Marine Corps. Cadet Townsend, the United States Navy. Cadet Contreras, the United States Air Force. Cadet Amba, the United States Coast Guard. And Cadet Baca, American Civil Services. There is a table at the front of the room whose meaning may not be familiar to some. Through 7 major wars, over 565,000 Americans have been placed behind bars and barbed wire. 80,000 have died in captivity. They answered our nation's highest calling and have yet to return from the field of battle. We have set a table for these men and women who are not able to be with us tonight. The lone table symbolizes the frailty of one prisoner against his oppressors. The table is round to show our concern for them is never ending. The white tablecloth represents the purity of their dedication to our country. The single rose reminds us of their families and loved ones who have been left behind. The ribbon tied so prominently on the base is reminiscent of the yellow ribbon worn on the breasts of thousands, symbolizing their unyielding determination and faith. The Bible represents faith in a higher power and a pledge to our country. The black napkin stands for the emptiness these warriors have left in the hearts of their families and friends. The slice of lemon reminds us of their bitter fate. There is salt on the plate, symbolic of our country's tears. The glasses are inverted, as they cannot toast with us tonight. The chair is empty, they are not here. To the soldier who fought on land, throwing off aggressors to protect our soil, we will remember your sacrifice. To the men and women of the Marine Corps that blaze the trail from sea to shore, ever willing to place their country before their own lives, we'll remember your sacrifice. To the sailor who sailed from sea to sea, protecting our way of life, we'll remember your sacrifice. To the airman who traversed the skies in order to make our country a safe haven for democracy, we'll remember your sacrifice. To the Coast Guardsmen who protect America's coasts, ports, and inland waterways, we will remember your sacrifice. To the civilians who serve as civil service employees, who support U.S. foreign policies and help drive diplomatic principles and initiatives worldwide. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a moment of silence to remember those who so honorably served our nation.
Delta Flight Commander, come forward and present your Grog ingredient. On behalf of Big D Flight, we proudly present KJ's missing finger. Echo Flight Commander, come forward and present your Grog ingredient. On behalf of E-Flight, I present to you Nova 6.
Foxtrot, Flight Commander, come forward and present your grog ingredient.
On behalf of that flight, I present to you a flask of formula.
Mr. Vice, has the grog been thoroughly mixed and prepared?
Yes, Mr. Vice.
At this time, will you please join and stand with me and join me in a couple of toasts. Ladies and gentlemen, I propose a toast to the colors. Ladies and gentlemen, I propose a toast to the Commander-in-Chief.
Mr. President, point of order.
The President recognizes Mr. Vice.
I propose a toast to the Chief of Staff of the United States Air Force.
Here, here.
I propose a toast to our senior aerospace science instructor and our aerospace science instructor.
Here, here.
I propose a toast to all men and women in uniform serving worldwide protecting our freedom.
Here, here.
I propose a toast to our distinguished guests of the head table.
Here, here, here.
At this time, I'll be accepting toasts from our flight commanders on behalf of their flight. Alpha Flight Commander, present your toast.
Mr. President, point of order.
The President recognizes Alpha Flight Commander.
On behalf of A Flight, we would like to present a toast to our unit getting exceed standards on our unit evaluation.
Here, here.
Bravo Flight Commander, present your toast. The President recognizes Cadet Del Campo.
For the new year and for many new years.
Here, here.
Here, here.
Charlie Flight Commander, present your toast.
Mr. President, point of order.
The President recognizes Cadet Lay.
E-Flight presents a toast to senior staff.
Here, here, here. Here, here. Here, here. Delta Flight Commander, present your toast.
Mr. President, point of order.
The President recognizes Cadet Zinn.
We present a toast to Shane Dennison.
Here, 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 here.
Echo Flight Commander, present your toast.
Mr. President, point of order.
The President recognizes Cadet Contreras.
On behalf of E-Flight, to the future prosperity of the United States of America, and the total annihilation of ISIS.
And last, but certainly not least, Foxtrot Flight Representative, please present your toast.
Mr. President, point of order.
The President recognizes Cadet Lopez.
If I would like to make a toast to all the men and women helping protect us from the fire to downhill.
You're here.
You're here.
At this time, I'll be accepting 5 toasts from any member of the mess.
Mr. President, point of order.
The President recognizes Cadet Sia.
Although Cadet Shima has not been with us for a couple months now, I'd like to make a toast to him for all the efforts he has put in and the motivation he's put into us.
Mr. President, point of order.
The President recognizes Cadet Wojcicki.
I would like to make a toast to the 8th graders who came today.
Here, here.
Here,
recognizes Cadet Tashima.
Mr. President, point of order.
President recognizes Cadet Contreras.
I'd like to propose a toast to Colonel Young.
Hear, hear.
I believe that was five. And if you can't hear, the grog is bubbling and it's hungry for you right now.
Mr. President, one last point of order.
The President recognizes Cadet Sanchez.
I'd like to propose to the parents that helped us.
Hear, hear.
Hear, hear.
Group, you now may sit at ease. Now, Mr. Vice, you spoke of rule violations, and have those rules been published, and did the members of the mess know to arrive on time?
Yes, Mr. President. The rules have been published, and the guests were informed to arrive on time. Those of you who have failed to arrive on time will be recognized after dinner to serve.
Absolutely, they will. Very good then, let's let dinner be served. While dinner is being served, you may mingle amongst your chat amongst yourselves. Thank you.
Get a close up on Noel's race.
So how's everybody doing?
No, I got out the car at 6:30. I arrived at 6:30. Chief.
The first grog to be done, Mendoza violated rule number one.
No, I got here.
Decided to bring amongst us.
Not my group commander.
Abuse. Not that one.
We have other things to talk about. Not that.
So, what are the questions?
First, is water wet?
Of course!
Enough! We're gonna solve this. Alright? So, if water is wet, why?
Water isn't wet. There is no possibility that water can be wet. The definition of being wet is surrounded by water. Water cannot surround itself, therefore, it's not wet.
It's true. That's good. Solid
point. If it's not wet, then it's dry. I think we can all agree when I say that water is wet.
Oh my god, that is not how it works. In order for something to be wet, it must also be able to be dry. And water can't be wet because it has the inability to be dry.
Right, right.
That's true.
That just doesn't make sense.
Cadet Aguayo, you need to stop saying stuff doesn't make sense. That's not a valid argument. Water can't be wet because water can't surround itself. Something when it's surrounded by water is wet, not water itself.
Well, technically, water molecules surrounded by water molecules.
Okay.
Also,
okay.
Because it's a liquid, it's inherently wet.
So water's wet because it's water?
No! Not my group here.
Abuse of power.
Sit down. Sit down. Sit down.
Guys, I really don't care. As long as you let me eat my soup.
Soup.
Wait,
soup.
Soup.
What are you talking about?
It is a soup, just a very cold soup.
Cereal is a salad. Clearly. Obviously, because you don't pour the broth into the ingredients in a soup. You pour the dressing on the salad.
Exactly.
Therefore, cereal is a salad.
Right?
No.
Wait.
No.
But
no.
You don't drown your salad in dressing. You drown the cereal in milk.
Yeah,
it's
like
soggy
cereal.
No way.
The only people who hate
themselves
like
soggy
cereal.
Anybody who thinks this cereal is a salad thing is dumb. Cereal is clearly a soup.
Yeah.
It's clearly a soup. The milk is the broth. Think of chicken noodle soup. Milk is broth. The Cheerios are the chicken. The Cheerios are the chicken and the noodle. Is there a question about that? Does everybody, are we on the same level here?
What about people who don't eat their cereal with milk?
Those people are monsters.
Unless some of you guys do that, then you guys aren't monsters.
But I don't think it's a super salad necessarily.
Yeah, actually.
Because you can eat it without milk.
Yeah, actually,
no.
By Boyd's definition, cereal is its own thing. It's neither a soup or a salad.
Sure.
Yeah. Not my group command.
Oh my god, sit down, Baka. I swear to god, I'm gonna hustle you. Go, sit down. So, what do we think? What do we think? Cadet Stilts, what do you think?
I think this is stupid.
It's not stupid. These are important
philosophical
questions.
These are deep. These have been plaguing our class for years.
Stop.
Another question. Right?
Yeah, like is we've discussed this one. What constitutes
a
sandwich? In fact,
a popcorn.
All of you, come up. Return your chair right now and use your pencil to answer.
A Pop-Tart is a sandwich.
There's
no Pop-Tart's a pizza.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. Shouldn't a burrito be a sandwich too? No. No, okay, that's only one tortilla. No, a sandwich is an ingredient inside.
piece of bread. One piece of bread. A Pop-Tart is two pieces of bread. How?
Guys, why can't we all just get along? Why do you have to argue these
questions? Why do you have to
question
sandwich?
A Pop-Tart!
Mr. President, the violations are extremely rampant. However, I feel that enough has been dealt with and the mess has been restored. At this time, I, on behalf of the mess, that the Grog be closed.
Mr. Vice, I agree with you. Justice has been achieved and order in the mess has been restored. At this time, the Grog is now closed. Ladies and gentlemen,
Thompson!
What's up?
Yeah, I mean, why do you think I smiled directly into the camera? I mean, model.
Okay, I'm good.
We're gonna get in trouble. I knew this was gonna be very bad. I wanted to cry. Yeah. Oh, yeah,
dude,
sorry about that.
Last year, I had it four times.
It was so good. The Grog was so good.
Did you?
Oh. Christina, no.
Over there, we're gonna take a picture, okay?
Yes, sir!
All right.